To make the wheat naan, we need a wheat flour for all-purpose flour, yogurt, baking powder, olive oil, and we have the yeast mixed into the water and the milk. Hello everyone, welcome to my home kitchen. I'm Bhavna, and today I'm going to show you how you can make the wheat naan. So we have the wheat flour. I took the half of wheat flour. It's actually more than half of wheat flour, and the all-purpose flour, half of all-purpose flour. And I prepared this yeast mix. I boiled just a little bit water, almost about 85 degrees. You don't need to heat the milk too much, otherwise the yeast won't rise in it. So you need a perfect temperature to rise the yeast. So we have this mixture of yeast. I put the one pouch of yeast and one tablespoon of sugar and almost about half of a tablespoon salt into this mixture, and now it's ready. So first we're going to prepare the the flour. Mix the flour well. Instead of eating just the all-purpose flour, the maida naan, the wheat naan is better, and they taste delicious. So I'm going to add almost about 1 teaspoon of baking powder. So into the 1.5 cup of wheat flour and the 1 cup all-purpose flour, I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of baking powder. And now again mix the baking powder well. I'm going to add the almost 1 tablespoon of or 1.5 tablespoon of yogurt. I'm going to work with my hand, and before that we're going to add the oil. You can add the whatever oil you're using. I'm going to add the olive oil. So almost about 5 tablespoons of olive oil. Now we're going to knead the dough with this yeast mix. If you don't want to use the milk, you can also use the all water. But I used half of milk and half of water. We're going to knead the dough almost like a pizza dough. You can use the whole wheat flour if you want to, but I'm using the regular chapati flour, the roti flour. And also you can mix all three flours, actually the chapati flour, whole wheat flour, and a little bit of all-purpose flour. So our dough is almost ready, and this dough will almost become double, and that's where we know that it's perfectly fermented. And we're going to transfer this dough into the another bowl. We will need the big bowl. So we have this pot. I'm going to spray it. And we're going to transfer this dough into that bowl. our dough is ready, and we're going to place this into the big bowl. And on the top, you can sprinkle just a little bit of leftovers, the yeast mix. And we're going to cover it. And this takes almost 1.5 or 2 hours, and it gets done, and it will rise almost double. So we will see after 2 hours. Our naan dough has risen in double. Our naan dough has been fermenting for a while now, and it's ready. So I'm going to take a little ball. Dust into the flour. And roll it. You can roll it them in any shape you like. I'm just doing a round one. You can do triangle or oval shape, however you like it. We had the pan already heating. I'm going to add the naan. You can also bake the naan into the oven at the high temperature. That also comes out nice. But this one becomes more soft and you know, easy way to do it. Or if you want to bake many at the you know, one time, then oven is the best option. You can use this, and you can bake again on that. So this almost give a kind of you know, oven temperature directly to the naan. But if you don't have this, you can still do into the pan, into the. And as soon as you take off from the stove, spread some butter on it. I'm going to do the rest of the naan now. And this is a wheat naan, so it's healthy to eat. And earlier I said that you can use the whole wheat flour even. And again, we brought onto the rack. And keep the stove temperature high.